Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Celebration City. And I thank you all for joining us on this lovely Friday evening. We're going to start off tonight with some worship. I just want to open up in prayer. Thank you, Father God, for this time of worship and gathering and fellowship for us to get together and build up one another in your word and in your identity. Thank you, Lord, for all these precious members of the body and for this time tonight. Amen.
Let's all stand up together. And Lord, we just cast all our cares on you. We just come here free to reconnect with you, to remember where we come from, Lord, and just to abide in you and your love, Lord. Thank you.
What manner of love was given unto us, the Father calls us his sons. Born of the Word, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible through your Spirit, O God. It is you we adore, it is you praises are for. Only you the heavens declare. It is you, it is you. Holy, holy are you, awesome Father. Holy, holy is your name, O Lord. Holy, holy are you, Holy Spirit. Holy are your sons too, born of you. It is you we adore. It is you, only you. Behold what manner of love was given unto us, the Father calls us his sons. Born of the Word, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible through your Spirit, O God. It is you we adore. It is you praises are for. Heavens declare, it is you, it is you. And holy, holy are you, awesome Father. And holy, holy is your name, O Lord. Holy, holy are you, Holy Spirit. It is you, only you. And holy, holy are you, awesome Father. Holy, holy is your name, O Lord. Holy, holy are you, Holy Spirit. Holy are your sons too, born of you. Father, adore. It is you, only you. It is you.
Separate me from your love.
nothing can separate me from your love.
Shout it out.
Nothing can separate.
Nothing.
Nothing can separate. Nothing can separate me from your love. Oh, nothing can separate. Oh, nothing can separate. Nothing can separate me from your love. Oh, nothing can separate. Nothing can separate.
Finished work, Jesus. No thing can separate us. Hallelujah. We praise you for that, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Family. your blood flows through my veins, and I'm no longer a slave to fear, 'cause I am a son of God, and I'm no longer a slave to fear, 'cause I am a son.
Oh,
Thank you, Father. We just praise you and worship you. Who is like our God? Hallelujah. We just lift you up, Father. Who is like you? There is no one like you. You are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We exalt you and we worship you. Hallelujah.
Bye.
Father, we thank you for this time of worship. We thank you that our souls found rest, and that we can rest not only in this time of worship, but every moment of every day, that we can choose to rest in you, because Jesus, our lives are hidden in you. And we just thank you for that, Lord. We just are ready to receive from you. We bless the rest of this time together tonight, Lord. Our ears are open. Our hearts are open to hear your words, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Father. We love you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, worship team. Good evening, everybody. I just want to thank you again all for joining us. I've only been gone for 1 week and already feels like I haven't seen you guys in so long. It's so good to see everybody's faces. Yeah, all right, well, I just wanted to start off this evening with some testimonies and give everybody an opportunity to come up and share something that happened in their life this weekend, or maybe another part of the body or their family. Does anyone have any testimonies they wanted to share tonight? Sephora?
So something very practical, and it might sound silly, but I was encouraged by it. So I'm sure, like everyone, there's situations in our lives that cause us a lot of stress and anxiety, things that, you know, when we particularly think about them, it really stirs us up, and it's hard sometimes to let them go. And so I was dealing with this type of thing. And my husband reminded me, I thought you cast your cares on the Lord. Did you not do that? Why are you taking it up again? Why are you letting it get to you? And at first I was peeved, and I'm like, you're not hearing me. You're not listening to me. You don't understand my pain. And then we got home, and he was doing his thing, and I was like, okay, Lord, let me, you know, your word has the answer, so let me go to it. Let me just, you know, listen to you and be obedient and all that good stuff. And so I just took that time to look at that verse, you know, that talks about cast all your cares on the Lord. And I was Googling stuff just to get something to read to kind of encourage me and what have you. And very interestingly enough, so the same word of cast your cares on the Lord is the same cast that talks about the cloak that was cast on the donkey when Jesus sent his disciples to go get that donkey. And so it's a physical, like it's here. Literally, I was like, wow, okay, I can do that. So I went into another room, and I literally grabbed a pair of socks. I'm not even kidding you. And I took those socks, and I'm like, okay, Lord, this is my anxiety. This is the thing that drives me nuts, that I keep picking up, that I keep stressing over. And there was a chair, and I was like, okay, Lord, you're right there. So I literally, and I said, okay, so I physically, I don't have it anymore. That anxiety, that care, that stress, that worry is no longer in my possession because I gave it to him. So anytime the enemy is going to come and stir that up in me again and just lose my peace over it, I'll just be like, look, it's no longer mine. I gave it to him. He's dealing with it. Because a lot of times we want to take it, okay, how do I make this work? What do I need to do? What do I need to work to make this better? And so, you know, that's learning to truly give it to the Lord and to trust him that he knows what he's doing with it. And just to yield to him and to submit to him. So I hope that's encouraging. If you look like a fool in your house, look like a fool in your house, because whatever helps you, just give it to the Lord and let him take control of it. So love you guys. Be blessed by that.
Do we have any others? Last opportunity. Yes? Okay.
Hey guys, I was just telling one of the ladies here when I came here that just about nine and a half months ago, I was in an accident. We got hit by a tow truck, and before he got hit by the tow truck, I was singing R&B, hip hop, and when the tow truck hit us, the seatbelt took and shoved my trachea clear back and then off to the side, and so I went almost like, probably 7 months without really seeing, you know, and decided to just start working on my rapping. And just like the other day, I was in the park and everything, just freestyling, just working on my rapping and stuff. And I pushed out, in an hour and a half, I pushed out five songs. an hour and a half. You know, and one of the last songs that I did, I was really, really touched by God, because it was actually a prayer that I actually was praying that actually turned into a rap, and it was actually called My Request. And it was just really powerful. And I knew that God was just sitting on his throne, just like, yeah. That's my boy. Come on. Come on. Oh, yeah. Can I have an amen up here? And I was like, because every time, I mean, all you guys know, when you're touched by the Holy Spirit, you know, you just get that where you just want to choke, you know? And that's why I just knew, okay, God, I know you like this. I know you love this song, you know? And it was just really powerful, and I was just so thankful that God was able to touch me, and the Holy Spirit was able to touch me by that
maybe we can give you the prayer. You can give it to us sometime.
Okay? Yeah.
Good testimony, brother. Come on, sit down. Hallelujah. I got a testimony from Pastor Joy in India, and we were just over there. And he was telling us about how he got up amongst a group of people up in the Himalayas, and they were all snake charmers. If you've ever seen anything like that on the Geographic Channel, where they got the little baskets and the guy's sitting there with the flutes, and those snakes come up. And I remember I was at the Taj Mahal a couple of years ago, and they had one out there, but they kind of made them illegal because tourists were... They were afraid the tourists are going to get bit, you know. Probably some of them did. But anyway, this was a whole little tribe, a little group of them. And one of the people heard Joy when he was up preaching and wanted to know if he would come over and pray for his wife. I think it's right. Joy, if I'm telling this wrong, forgive me. But he went over and prayed for him, and the person got healed. And the whole group of them got saved. They'd never seen any kind of power like that before. And they put away their snake charming deal. I've got another one I've got to give on Joy, too, because I told him I'd give him these testimonies, and we get them written down. But this one was cool in the sense of, you know, the Hindu people are all totally into idols. And so from little kids, they learn how to have a little idol in their room, and they pray to that idol and some greasy god or some creepy god. What is something about that idol? And so some people had asked him to come and pray for a daughter or something. And he went over, and he was talking with them. And he got their little idol off of the counter there, and he put it down. He put his foot on top of it. Now, these people have extreme fear of hurting or making these gods angry. And they were thinking that this God was going to just zap him. And he squished it. He squished that little idol, just squished it. And they were so blown away. He preached the gospel to them and a whole bunch of families through them all come to know the Lord. So, praise God. Step on those idols. Stay away from the snakes.
All right, any more testimonies? Well, I have one I thought I'd share with you guys. as I mentioned earlier, we went on a short trip last weekend, just like very, very last minute book tickets like the night before. I just went for 2 days to Las Vegas. And the beginning of the trip, I asked God to give me an encounter with somebody that he just bring part of the body that needed ministering or healing or something. I just really wanted to, you know, go be around somebody and just minister to him. And the first day went by, and, you know, we went out to the sun and everything, and second day went by was actually the night we're getting ready to leave, and we're in line to go into this building, and there's this guy standing behind me, and I started talking with him. His name's Victor. He's in the Air Force, and he happened to be in Vegas for 2 to 3 weeks for this special training he was required to do, and we were talking, and he started telling me about this knee injury he had. He's had it for years, something with like a ACL and his meniscus. I don't know, they work together, but anyways, he's been hurt for like many years, and they offered him a surgery to repair him, essentially. But if he would have gone through with the surgery, then he would have been medically discharged from the Air Force. So he chose to go without it. And we're talking, and I told him, I'm like, you know, your knees can be better. He kind of like looks at me. I'm like, yeah. I'm like, do you want your knees to feel better? And he's like, I'm like, do you mind if we pray for you? And he goes, oh yeah, sure, sure. Pray for me. And he was younger. He's probably like late 20s or so. And so I go to start praying, and I don't have the opportunity, because as soon as I said that, it like lit this fire in him. He's like, oh my gosh, I'm so glad you guys are believers. Oh, I've been so alone for so long. And he just opened up the last few years to us. And turns out that he kind of had this born again experience where he found God and his life was changing. And then the opportunity came up for him to go into the Air Force. And he said he felt really called at that time to go on missions, but he didn't listen and he disobeyed. And he joined the Air Force, and he said ever since then, he just felt very like disconnected and not able to be around the body and everything. So he was actually just praying a few days before, you know, for some kind of like encounter, and we ended up meeting him that night. So that was really cool. We kind of just like relit this fire, and we just talked. We ended up standing out in the line. So our time came up to go in, and we ended up talking with him for 2 hours outside. And at the end, he was asking if he could spend the rest of the night with us. You know, we're like, of course, yeah. And I kept hearing that I needed to pray in my head, though. And so I was like, oh, can we pray for you? He's like, sure. And, you know, so we pray over his knee, and right when we get done, he's just kind of like looking, and I'm like, how do you feel? And he's like, I feel so good. My knee feels so good right in the middle of you guys praying. It feels amazing. And I'm like, does it usually come and go like that? And he's like, no, I've been in constant pain for so long. And so that was really cool. It was just really awesome because, you know, right at the end of the trip, he still found a way to sneak it in. And my whole point of sharing this was anytime you're open to, you know, getting closer to God or having an encounter or reaching out to somebody, and you ask for that, he's faithful to give that to you. So I just encourage you all to ask. All right. Well, thank you. If we're all done with testimonies, I want to jump into tithes and offerings. Thank you. So this is a confession for those of you who haven't watched us before, just something we believe as a church body here, and we proclaim. It can get a little repetitive at times, but if you ever take the time to really slow down and read the words, they're very powerful. So if you all want to join me. Father, we thank you for souls being saved, the sons of God revealed, miracles and healing in abundance, increase of the dominion of life, grace and favor multiplied to us. We give with joy for the kingdom. The mountain of lack is removed. We give and we receive. All right. So, financial covenants, they're really just a blessing from the Lord. It's just another way that we can experience him in our life in a very tangible, physical way. They're just promises that are there in Scripture, and if we hold on to them and we have faith for them, it just gives another opportunity for us to be blessed and see him manifest even more in our life. I want to encourage you all that anything you give in faith, it will be returned back to you abundantly. And if you have an area in your life you might need some financial help in right now, or just some more free time or something, it's a really good opportunity for you to sow into that. All right. If you guys want to join me in prayer, I'm going to pray over our tithes and offerings. Lord, thank you so much for this time of gathering with members of your body. I want to thank you for these financial covenants and promises you've given us to lay hold of and to walk in faithfully. Thank you, Lord, for your promise that everything we sow will return back in abundance, Father God. And for all the tithes we give back up to you, Father, we're just returning the blessings you've already gave us, and that you'll return them back abundantly and protect us. Amen. All right, I think Psalms is going to start off ministering to us this evening about love, if I'm correct.